Now we're going to focus on a trill exercise to master the same techniques we've been talking about in all the videos, especially the warm-up exercise using the jaw up and down to lock in from groove to groove. This trill exercise is available on the website as a download. Find a middle G or second line G in the staff. If you have problems finding it, you can just play a middle C on a piano. When you play your G, push down 1 and 3 to play the same note. It may be a little sharp on 1 and 3, so pull out your third slide a little bit. You just want to approximate the intonation. You can go back and forth to test it. So here's a sample of the trill exercise. To break it down into elements, we're first going to blow more on each beat. So beat 1, beat 2, beat 3, and beat 4. Open the lips, increase the airflow, and lock into the bottom of the groove. Kind of like a radar, feeling the notes. Now focus on the jaw, chin, bottom lip, exaggerating the motion. Every time you slur down, pop it down, and every time you slur up, pop it up from groove to groove. If you flipped over the top of any of the upper notes, that's probably because your chin is relaxing or crunching up, or your jaw is coming too high. Keep the chin firm and down. The reason I like using the jaw so much in slurs and trills is it locks into the note and you have a clearer sounding note when you go fast in your trills. Just using the side to center accent, you get a kind of smeared sound. It kind of skates on the surface of the note. For instance, you don't really hear each note pop out clearly. By using the jaw, chin, bottom lip, moving in one piece, it locks into the notes. You hear both notes very clearly. Now that's a trill. Now on to tuning the horn.